Hello and welcome to the feature of the week.
Our previous video, number 160, explained how to create forest plots using Monolix and Simulix interface in combination with R. We included only information about the uncertainty of fixed effects parameters, and the forest plots showed the probability of a typical subject's drug exposure to be inside a specific range of values.
We didn't include between subject variability, so these plots can't be used to predict individual exposure. In order to do this task, for example, to predict exposure in a future population or in different experimental conditions, we need to perform simulations that take into account between subject variability. In today's video, we will explain how to do this and how to automate the whole workflow for both examples: forest plots showing exposure of typical subjects and forest plots showing individual exposure, using lixoftConnectors R package. The R scripts we will create can be reused for multiple projects with minor modifications, making the process of creating forest plots more efficient. Let's consider the same model we used in the previous example. The model was developed on an adult population, and we would like to predict the exposure in a pediatric population. To do this, we will create simulations based on covariate values realistic for children. We assess the effect of covariates at different covariate subgroups. For example, they can be based on the quantiles of continuous covariates and modalities of categorical covariates. We can split the simulated individual profiles into these subgroups. Then we will calculate the AUC and Cmax values and create a forest plot using also these subgroups. The values presented on the y-axis correspond to the quantiles of continuous covariates and modalities of categorical covariates. There are some differences in the setup of the simulations used when creating forest plots showing individual exposure and forest plots showing covariate effects on exposure of a typical individual. We use the MLXPOP uncertain SA element to create forest plots that show individual exposure, because they contain information about values and uncertainties of both fixed effects and random effects, instead of MLX typical uncertain, which has random effects set to zero. Both of the elements are available in Simulix after importing a Monolix project that contains the results of standard error estimation. To create forest plots showing individual exposure, we create just one simulation group. Could create multiple simulation groups by splitting the used sets of covariates into quantiles before performing simulations, but having one simulation group and splitting results by quantiles of covariate values will be computationally more efficient and easier to prepare. When we will create forest plots to predict individual exposure, we will use covariate element with values of covariates taken from this file. This file contains sex and weight values of the pediatric population we want to simulate. We change the sampling method to sample from this table without replacements, since the file contains thousands of sets of covariates which are sorted by sex, which means that if we leave this setting as default, keep order, only one sex will be used in simulations. Instead of simulating just one typical individual per group, we simulate a population of, let's say, 100 or 1000 individuals. The more individuals we simulate, the more precise results will be, but calculation times will be longer. To create a forest plot, we divide the results by quantiles or modalities of covariates directly in R. Let's see now how to use lixoftConnectors R package to generate both types of forest plots in R based on our Monolix project. Let's start with a script that will automatize the workflow of creating forest plots for example 1, without using inter-individual variability. So this script will first source the R file that contains the function that we will use to plot covariate effects. Then we define certain variables that we will use later, for example, file path to the Monolix project, covariate values that will be used, reference values for covariates, as well as the number of replicates. Next, the script initializes lixoftConnectors to Monolix and loads the Monolix project, and then immediately exports it to Simulix. The first step that is done in Simulix is adding additional lines to calculate AUC, and then defining output element based on the AUC variable. So this output element will output AUC at time 24 hours. Next, it defines treatment element, so a treatment, single dose treatment of 100 milligrams at time 0. And it starts setting up the simulation by choosing elements that will be used in the simulation. So first we choose MLX typical uncertain SA as the population parameter element. And then it chooses output elements AUC24 and output element MLXCC, which outputs plasma concentration and will be used to calculate Cmax. Then the treatment element that we defined a few lines ago is also selected. Group size is then set to 1, as we are simulating only a typical individual. And then the reference covariate element is created with the reference values that provided through the variable in one of the first lines. Now, this reference element is selected in the simulation as well. And the default naming of the first group, simulation group 1, is changed to reference, so given a more meaningful name. Next step is to create multiple covariate elements containing covariate values that we want to plot. So this is done in this for loop, as well as adding simulation group for each of the covariate elements and setting newly created covariate elements to these groups. Next, the number of replicates is chosen. Replicates here is a variable that was defined in the beginning of the script. And then the simulation is run. After running the simulation, the script defines outcome elements. So first, outcome element AUC, which takes the value of AUC24 output. And then outcome element Cmax, which takes the maximum value of the output element MLXCC, which contains plasma concentrations. And then we need to define an endpoint that will use these two outcome elements. In the end, the script runs endpoints and outcomes, and the project is saved. And we use plot covariate effects function from the script that we sourced in the first line to actually create the forest plot. So this plot covariate effects function takes two arguments as input. One is the path to the Simulx file, and the second one is the name of the outcome element that we want to plot. You can find this script if you follow the link in the description. Now I will explain how the script plot forest plot for example 2 that includes between subject variability looks like. So it starts similarly as the previous example. So we source the function to plot the forest plot. We define some variables which include number of replicates and name of the Monolix project. We initialize lixoftConnectors to Monolix and load the project and immediately export it to Simulx. We again define additional lines to calculate AUC and create output element based on this AUC variable. And then define treatment element as a single dose of 100 milligrams. The next step is a bit different from example 1. So now we define MLX pop uncertain SA as a population parameter element that we are going to use instead of MLX typical uncertain. And then again, we choose to run simulation with output elements AUC24 and MLXCC and treatment element that we created a few lines ago. We set group size to large number, for example, 100. And then we define covariate element using the CSV file I showed you previously that contains covariate values that make sense for pediatric formulation. And we set this element to use in simulation. Next, we define the number of replicates and set sampling method without replacement. Then we save the project and run simulation. Script continues in the same way as example 1 script continued. So we define outcome AUC based on AUC24 output element and outcome Cmax based on the maximum value of MLXCC element. We can then define endpoints for AUC and Cmax, save the project, and run endpoints. After this is done, we will use plot individual exposure from the R file that was sourced on the first line. This function will take the results of our simulation and it will sort outcomes AUC and Cmax based on the quantiles of a distribution of continuous covariates and based on categories of categorical covariates. So this function takes a few more arguments. It takes a Simulex project name as an argument, it takes outcome element as an argument, takes information which covariates present in the simulation file are continuous, takes number of quantiles that are gonna be used to split continuous covariates in, and then labels argument, which is used to change the names of categories, quantiles, and covariates in order to have more meaningful names in the plot. The resulting forest plot will look like this. Again, you can download this script using the link that is provided in the description. Thank you and have a nice week.